So you can see that I have marked the points where I will be drilling it. The distance between the exterior drill point will be 8.8 cm and both will be parallel to each other. So that's how it will be looking. You can see both will be in the straight line when we will be putting them in the exterior portion of the base. So now now I will show you how I am drilling it. So we have done this this portion. We have put the stopper here to stop the rod from coming out, and we have cut out the base. The base is perfectly going in between these two block of wood, and you can see it is moving smoothly. I will put some graphite lubricant later on, but it's now we can see that it's okay. And it's perfectly moving fine. So next step, what we will do, we will fix this base with both of the end points permanently. And after that, it is not yet fixed. And after that, we will work with the y-axis. So let's see. Okay. So you can see that I have connected one end of the frame, and it's secured. Now I am using only one screw so that I can adjust it a little bit, and after adjusting it then I will lock it with other two screws. Here is the other part that I will put here, and before screwing that, I will first put the frame here, and after that I will screw, otherwise it will not be able to put it again. So this put it inside. So one side it's inside, another side there it goes. So it's now locked in place. Now after this we will screw it, and it's moving fine. So guys, as you can see, the x-axis is completed. Now the next task is y-axis. X-axis is moving perfectly. So next I will make the y-axis. So as the x-axis is done, now I will cut two wood pieces to hold the y-axis in position at both the end. So I will be cutting these two wood pieces with my jigsaw now, and then I will attach here, and I will lock them, and I will lock them in position, and so both the rods will move at the same time. So let's cut it. Okay guys, so I was doing the y-axis, and the y-axis is completed. I have put the block of wood here, and I have locked it with two screws from top, and also at this end. So both the x and y axis is completed successfully. I will show you how it moves. X axis moves fine. Y axis is little jammed, but I think some lubrication will help it. This is how it looks. So after this I will attach the pulleys in there, and I will attach the writing head, and I will attach the motors here in the two exterior bases. So guys, I am done with attaching the pulley and attaching the pulley here. So this side I will attach the pen, and so what I am thinking is to put a pen holder like this that will slide up and down. It will slide on these two stainless steel rods that I will put here. These rods and these holders are from old CD drives. You can easily find them if you have two or three CD drives. So this it will be attached with this wooden board, and this part is also from that CD drive. So this will be in it, and it will go up and down, and I will screw it here. So this servo I will be using, this is SG90 9G servo. So I will be putting it here, that will push it up and down. And this servo wire I will put an extension, and I will connect that with the CNC shield. There is slight change in the plan. First I thought I will mount it here, but that will create some problem with the belt alignment. So what I will do, I will cut a U here, I will cut it out like this, and then I will put the motor here. So now I will cut out this wood portion here. So what I did, I did two cut here using my hexo. After that I drilled multiple holes here, and I break this U part out. So I will do for that part also. So I have cut out, and this is how the bracket will be placed, that side also. So after this I will now mark the points, I will drill for the screws, and I will mount the motor. So guys, I have mounted the motors here at the end, and also I have put two nut here, sorry, two screws here to lock the rod inside, that side also, and this side I will now attach the pulley. I will align it parallel, and after that I will put the belt in it, and at last I will put the servo here to rise it up and down, and it will be done. So I have put the belt now. After this I have to lock the belt in this axis here, then it will be done. Okay guys, so the next plan, I will attach this aluminium. This was basically was the case of this SMPS, but this SMPS is not working right now, so I will put this aluminium casing here, and I have marked the points where I will drill hole for my Arduino to attach there. Okay, so my Arduino will come here, and I will use this 2 ampere SMPS to power this whole project, and I will put it here, and I will use multiple fans to cool down different parts like the SMPS and the drive motor drivers, and I am thinking to put other two of these at both the end to cool down the motor. I am not sure they will heat up or not, but it's better to put, so I will put them. So now I will drill and show you after assembling this. So as you can see, I have mounted the fan and the Arduino as well as the SMPS. So this is how it is looking right now. Okay guys, so now you can see I was trying to draw something. It is not so perfect. There is some calibration issue that I have to remove, and there is also a software issue there, because the problem that's coming is that Inkscape plugin is not working right now, and I'm just downloading some G codes from online and trying it out, the plugin. I am using Windows 10, maybe that may be a problem, but I will look into that. Rest, it is working fine. And I have figured out the home location. Home location is, so we have to manually, because I have disconnected the software, so I have to manually put it back into the home location here, like this. So this will come here, and that will be the home location. Rest it is fine. So just some software issue. I am thinking to modify the GRBL codec completely to customize my operation. Let's see how it will work.